You were first elected to the House of Representatives in the Republican wave of 2010. So you've never served in the minority in the House. With that in mind, what are you most looking forward to, Congressman, come January?
Well, my hope is that we can substantively get things done for the American people. And that's why I'm so proud of the work we're doing in the Problem Solvers Caucus, this group of bipartisan members, and Josh Gottheimer, my Democratic co-chair, leading the charge to reform the rules of the House, to let members be members, and let us legislate from a consensus being rewarded. Mm-hmm. And that, to me, is a critical piece. And as you watch these negotiations with Nancy Pelosi, I think we're in a position to get these rule reforms done, to get the institution working again rather than facing this gridlock that we see day in and day out.
On exactly that point, I read that you would consider voting for a Democratic speaker they would sign on to these reforms. Are you saying you would support Nancy Pelosi if she would sign on to reforms that would reward bipartisanship?
This is the bizarre world that I'm willing to go into because I care so deeply about the American people being left behind in this gridlock of Washington, D.C., that I'd be willing to consider that. And other Democratic candidates have reached out to us for our support. And I will tell you, so long as you're reforming the institution for the American people to get it working again so that members can get rewarded for consensus and bipartisan legislation, I'm open to that type of vote being taken for a Democratic speaker.
Not to be cynical, but maybe that's more of a statement of how unlikely it is that anyone in a leadership position would sign on to losing any of their power. I don't know.
Yeah, but if they need to become Speaker of the House, don't lose sight of the power of 218 votes in order to get it done.
Excellent point.